This morning in the Rhode Show kitchen, we are cooking with Go Providence. They brought us Lola's in the kitchen today. Chef Blake is here to make carne asada tacos. We also have the perfect margarita that we'll be making in a little bit. But let's go over the ingredients for the main dish here. What do we need?
All right, so what we've got here so far is this is beef. It's the flat meat. It's a piece of the sirloin. Mm-hmm. It's in some marinade that we made. It's tomatoes, onions. Just kind of a general marinade.
Okay.
That's gonna go on some white corn tortillas and get a little bit of garnish with some grilled onions, some queso fresco, which is a like fresh cow's milk cheese,
mm-hmm.
Traditional in Mexico. A little bit of scallions, some cilantro, some jalapenos if you like it a little warmer. And this is a chimichurri. It's kind of like a, like South American pesto. It's parsley, garlic,
okay.
A lot of cilantro, a little bit of oil, a little bit of vinegar.
I feel like I want to smell this now.
It's a very general condiment in South America that, you know.
I see where you're going with that. Yeah, kind of like a pesto. So
a little bit of avocado and some limes, and
yum.
We're all good to go.
Good to go is right. I gotta say, I love tacos, but when you're cooking them at home and you're selecting this meat, what should you look for?
Typically, what you're going for is just something that, you know. Obviously, you see it right now. It's got a nice bright red color to it. There is no mm-hmm. like kind of like graying or discoloration. When you do buy this particular cut, there will be a little bit of fat on it that you have to clean off of it.
Okay.
Other than that, it's just, you know, it's kind of a nice, like, about yay big. It's a little bit thin.
Mm-hmm.
It's actually like this part of the cow right here.
Okay. Interesting. Keeping it thin, though, when you're chewing it.
Absolutely.
When you want it in a taco, you don't want these huge bites. Now you're chewing on it for like a day and a half with just one bite. Good. All right. We've got great ingredients. And we've also got a margarita coming up a little bit later in the show. We're going to tell you how to make that. Back to you. It is great, Megan. You know, we are getting ready for Cinco de Mayo, so we have Lola's in with us, a great restaurant down in Providence. You guys have a whole menu of margaritas.
Absolutely.
Tell us a little bit about that, Amy.
Our menu consists of about 50 different tequilas.
Mm-hmm.
Then we have a bunch of different margaritas. They're all kind of named after personalities. So you might come in one day feeling spicy, you're going to grab a spicy. Come in feeling, you know, sweet,
mm-hmm.
grab yourself a sweet.
Okay.
Today we're obviously going to be making our classic Lola, which is by far the most popular drink that we sell.
All right. So let's get to it. How
sure.
do we make this margarita?
Well, the ingredients that we have are orange juice, triple sec, lime juice, and sour mix. Both of these are fresh squeezed and created in-house.
Mm-hmm.
And then obviously tequila. You can choose from a variety of different tequilas.
Mm-hmm.
Añejo, Reposado. We have a silver here. So
okay.
we'll start with the silver.
I'm pouring that over some ice.
Yep, right over the ice.
Make sure it's nice and cold.
Right to the bevel, so you don't want to fill it too much.
Okay.
Add a little bit of triple sec. I just like a little dash.
All right.
I also love a little bit of orange juice. You don't have to do orange juice,
That's
but
interesting.
It is popular. It makes it a little bit sweeter. A little splash of lime juice. And a whole mess load of sour mix.
All right.
Sweeten it right up.
You need that for a margarita.
And I'm going to shake it up. You can obviously blend it if you choose.
Mm-hmm.
It requires a little bit more.
Couple options
yeah.
in the summertime.
I like it on the rocks.
There it is,
right
with a salted
there.
Rim.
Yep, you can absolutely do a sugar rim as well.
Okay. And
really
then you can even throw an extra lime in there
yeah,
if you
of course.
Want. There
throw
you go.
Right
All right,
there.
Amy, excellent. This margarita is going to go great with our carne asada tacos coming up a little later in the show. Back to you.
What a day it's been. Chef Blake is here from Lola's in the kitchen.
Smells great in the kitchen.
Excellent. It does smell great.
Got tacos going. Got a little bit of this, a little bit of that going on. What
Tell
are we
us
doing
what
now?
We've got going on.
Well, what I've got going right now is I have the carne asada on the grill. Some of it's a little more done than the rest. I just mm-hmm. added some more in case, you know, we get a little more hungry than we have been
I'm sure we will.
This is very thin, so I'm assuming it cooks pretty fast.
Absolutely. You know, on our, like, I would typically cook it on a gas grill at the restaurant.
Okay.
On this grill pan. I mean, even now, this has only been going for about 2 minutes, so
doesn't take long.
That's really all it takes.
Right.
Quick meal, get it ready for the whole family.
Absolutely. And I've cut it down. Normally, I would have a little bit larger pieces,
mm-hmm.
But I've cut it down into these smaller strips because this is how we would cut it at the restaurant to serve it in the tacos.
Okay. Right. Makes a lot of sense. And how popular are these tacos? I mean, I'm sure you have a lot of other favorites on the menu.
Yeah.
Well.
I mean, we've got at this point, you know. 5 or 6 different types of tacos that sell pretty regularly, but
mm-hmm.
this is probably, this is definitely one of the larger sellers of the group.
Right.
Top sellers, we like that. And of course, Cinco de Mayo, coming up this weekend. So I'm sure a lot of people will be headed out to Lola's. Remind everyone where you guys are located.
We're right down in the water in Providence. It's 525 South Water Street.
I love that.
You know, right next to Whiskey Republic, we got a huge patio, picnic tables, all sorts of cool stuff. You know, like I said, right on the marina.
Nice.
You guys were telling me, too, you made some kind of like a roof deck balcony.
Yeah, there's the restaurant itself has two levels.
Uh-huh.
And right off the upstairs dining room, we've got another like second patio area.
Love to eat outside around this time
of
year.
It's great.
And with great food and you're outside, the weather's good. That's all good.
All right.
So at this point, I'm going to go ahead and fire a couple of tortillas up. You just want to kind of get them warm.
That just going to soften them up so it's easy to fold?
Yeah, the water that's left in them will kind of like steam a little bit so that, you know, they're going to have, you know, at this point, if I were to fold this in half, it would
right.
break.
Right.
Yeah.
But you can even actually see it starting to steam a little bit.
If you don't have one of these cool pans at home, what do you suggest?
You could even do this in just like a, you know, a saute pan.
Okay.
And if you don't have a nonstick, just a little tiny bit of oil, a couple of drops.
Perfect.
You don't need to make
them.
You don't need them to swim or anything like that. Just enough to get them to not stick to it.
Okay.
All right.
At this point, sneak in here real quick.
Yeah, please.
Grab ourselves a spoon.
Okay.
So this is actually one of the tacos that's going to be featured on our new street food menu.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
So it's going to be the grilled carne asada. This is a little bit of the chimichurri we talked about earlier.
Yeah, I'm actually going to turn this fan on for us,
just because we're getting a little smoky.
We'll get it going.
We are. So,
yum.
A couple of little pieces of steak.
Good.
And this actually is also going to get a little bit of grilled onion.
Okay.
Now, these were red onions that I did in a very similar fashion, just on the grill. Got a nice char on them, and then I steamed them a little bit in order to soften them up. And then this gets a little bit of queso fresco.
Okay.
Wow, this
a little bit of cilantro, a little more of the chimichurri on top.
Why not? Throw it all on there.
And then
some of this.
And then at this point, we've got some green onions. If you want to add a little bit of avocado to it.
Okay. Some of these on.
A lot
avocado,
of some jalapenos.
Good.
And we're good to go.
All right, so I'm going to put this in. Best way of folding this, or just whatever works for you?
Whatever works for you.
All right, so we'll fold this up. You know, it is so much easier to fold since you did heat them up.
You do that. I'm like getting a facial over here from all the steam. That's nice. I'll drink my margarita at the same time. Good?
Good.
Seal of approval by Will Gilbert. All right, don't forget, you can find the recipe for these tacos and for that perfect margarita that we made earlier on our website. Make sure you check out Lola's too. All the information's on WPRI.com.